We want to get to breaking news now that's been developing throughout our evening news today. Chicago police have filed charges against three people for killing a pregnant teenager and cutting the baby from her womb.
The suspects are a mother, a daughter, and a third person accused of helping commit those crimes. There they are. They're their mugshots. WGN's Patrick Elwood was at the news conference a short time ago. He's live at Chicago Police Headquarters with the latest. Patrick.
Micah and Joe, good evening to you. This investigation taking a huge step forward today with the filing of those charges. Those three people remain in custody. They're expected in bond court tomorrow. Two with murdering this young lady. The third, as you mentioned, with helping them cover up this horrific crime.
On the 7th of May, CPD received a break in the missing person investigation and learned that Ms. Ochoa was in communication with one of the offenders, which brought us to the area of 77th and Pulaski. Ultimately, DNA evidence and interviews led us to the three offenders that are now charged. I'm sad to report that on the 14th of May, detectives executed a search warrant and our investigation took a terrible turn while at the residence on the 4100 block of West 77th Place.
Police say the teen was lured to a home at 77th and Karlov on April 23rd by a woman who used a Facebook group to offer a free stroller and other baby items. The two had previously met as well, authorities say. According to neighbors, then that day, a 46-year-old woman who lives at that residence, Clarissa Figueroa, claimed that she had given birth to a baby, but he wasn't breathing. He was rushed to Christ Hospital, where he remains in grave condition. The break in the case came when a family friend told detectives Marlon had been in communication with this woman on that Facebook site. That led police to that neighborhood, and they just started knocking on doors. They started talking to a 24-year-old woman at that residence who told detectives her mother, 46-year-old Clarissa, was at the hospital and she had just given birth to a baby. That's when police say they knew they were onto something. They got DNA from the baby's dad, Giovanni Lopez, and then went to Christ Hospital, got DNA from the baby and from Clarissa, which did not come back to be a match. On May 14th, detectives executed a search warrant at that home.
There's bleach and clean solutions were discovered at that time, and the four individuals who were at the house were brought into Area South for interviews. Later on that evening, while detectives are doing their search, they find a garbage can on the premise, which is kind of in a hidden area on the premise. And unfortunately, that's when they discover the remains of Marlon.
Clarissa Figueroa and Desiree Figueroa are each charged with murder. Police say Desiree was the first one to confess that she helped her mother kill Marlon by strangling her with some sort of cord. Her body was discovered in a garbage can at their home. Another person, 40-year-old Peter Bobek, has been charged with assisting them to cover up the crime. They will all be in bond court tomorrow.
So when asked about a motive, the superintendent said he could only speculate, and his speculation is that these women just wanted to raise this child as their own. Again, bond court tomorrow. Reporting live from police headquarters at 35th of Michigan, Patrick Elwood, WGN News. Back to you guys in the studio.